Okay, thank you, Henk, for this presentation. So I can now present what we actually did with Thousand Eyes over the last 2 years. So we started with Thousand Eyes, I think, in April 2017 with the pilot. So Nick was helping us in that at that moment. So my profile, I'm Maarten van der Berg, principal consultant in CGI. I'm a connectivity architect in NXP for already more than 5 years. I'm busy in the DC-LAN area and network performance management, and working as a contractor for NXP. Just as Henk showed, we have quite a large install base with Thousand Eyes Enterprise Agents in NXP, predominantly in Europe and Asia, and we are also expanding in US. So out of these Enterprise Agents, we do perform tests, and those tests are shown in our next slides. So predominantly when we did the pilot, we had an issue in our secure environment. So we have a factory and also a certificate server in Hamburg that communication over the wider network had to be very good. And they had quite some issues. And what you see here is what Thousand Eyes saw as issues in the network in October 2017. After that, we have deployed an enterprise agent, and we measured, we did some tests to see what was wrong. We identified multiple issues in the wide area network, in the LAN, in several aspects. And in November, the situation was like this. So no issues anymore. So, and that was due to the fact that we had 1,000 agents deployed. So that's a good example of how we already in 2017 solved issues. Then this is another one, Hamburg Kaohsiung, for the same secure environment. We identified that we also had quite some huge packet loss issues. And we were then looking to that. We saw that the Hamburg LAN was causing the issue. So this is also a very important learning. So Thousand Eyes doesn't show you what it is exactly wrong, but it shows you where it is wrong. And that is really important in troubleshooting, because where do you start if you have issues? So it really gives you the point where you have to look and have to search for default. So if we would have had the device layer of Thousand Eyes, we would have been able to click down and then see more detail of the LAN, but we did not have that at the moment, so we started in our OLAP tooling to see what the issue was. So we had a very overloaded LAN core switch that caused the issue. So that was identified by Thousand Eyes. This is also a nice one. At this moment we were integrating the NXP and Freescale networks. NXP acquired Freescale a few years ago, and we were still integrating the networks. And yeah, this is what the network team, our colleagues, didn't like, because they played around and did some changes, but the change went wrong. And there was an outage for a very important R&D application, and yeah, we could really see that they have messed up the network. So they created a routing loop, and they didn't even know themselves. So it was wrong, so they corrected that, but that it had this consequence, and that we could see this. This was really annoying for them, because they said, oh, we did a bad job on this. So yeah, we have to prepare this change much better. So this gives indeed good visibility. So that's nice. Yeah, this one is also a nice one. So if you look into the web performance part of Thousand Eyes, you can also have a very detailed breakdown of page loads. And we were every time in a discussion with vendors, and that in this case it was IBM delivering the Doors NG application, but we also had it with Cyforma, SaaS application. They always said to us, your network is to blame, because the application doesn't perform, and fix it in your network. And with this, we could identify the page loads for every detailed step in the page load. And we could show them, here, look over here, you miss 3 seconds here, 4 seconds there, your application is not right. So why does this page load take so long? And they didn't have an answer, and they corrected that, and we have found 16 web application faults alone in this application, and IBM had to fix that. So we really could prove that it was in their application. The same was true for Sci Pharma, that was even worse. So we have corrected many, many times the application, and that led to enormous improvement of the application itself. Okay, then some more about the Skype issues, nice things that we discovered over there. So we had, I think it was last year, January, we had quite massive issues in Skype in Austin. Management complained a lot, so we had to dig into that with the task force. And we didn't have an enterprise agent in Austin, so we deployed one very fast on a VM. And then in 1 hour, we already identified 5 issues that we had between the site in Austin and the Skype online backend. We want to highlight 2, one internet service provider issue we saw, and also the Microsoft Skype egress point. So what we found out in just an hour, that we had quite some packet loss occasions, and we found out that we had a level 3 ISP issue. So from Austin we go into the Microsoft network via the internet, and we saw that one router had a packet loss of 30%. So level 3 was our internet access provider in Austin, so we could call them and say, this is wrong, this is your IP address, you have packet loss on this router, please fix. And they came back and they said, oh yeah, and indeed, we see it, and we fixed that. And it was fixed in 1 day, and then it was fine again. So that was one of the 5 issues that we identified. And then the Skype, Microsoft Skype egress point issue in Austin. So what we saw is NXP was connected to Dublin, that was the initial setup of the Skype Online infrastructure. So everybody connects to the Skype backend in Dublin. At that moment in time, they were spreading that across the world. So they had multiple egress points, and they created ones in US, in APAC, and so on. And since that was happening, we had a Skype issue, heavy Skype issue, so 20 to 30% of the calls were bad. And we looked into 1,000 eyes, and what we saw, that we hopped between the Skype backends in Iowa, Texas, and Canada. So we called Microsoft and said, what are you doing? So our site in Austin connects to Canada to have Skype for the Skype backend. That's not right. And also, we don't want to have 3 backends, so Iowa and all those 3. That should only be 1, and the one in Texas. And they, how do you see that? We had a call, we showed them, and they said, okay, we want to fix that. So in, I think, 1.5 week, they fixed it. So then we were at the Texas backend. So this is what we saw, and we saw this one line increase, the 1 millisecond showing the line to Canada. And also the IP address was from Canada. So then some of the lessons learned. It took quite a while before we interpreted the 1,000 eyes test results right. So you really have to dig into how 1,000 eyes measures, because this really gives you insight in what is really behind. So the technicians that we have to convince internally in our organization, they say, I'll rely on my own tools, and you really have to see how the tests are done so that you make the right conclusions. So that took quite a while for us, but that's okay. With regards to the endpoint agent use, we initially thought that we would use that more often than the enterprise agent, but it turns to be the other way around, and that was due to the fact that in Europe we have quite some privacy regulations, and to have a plugin in your browser that possibly can also have privacy sensitive data locked, that is was not approved by the Works Council right away. So we had to work together with them to make it all work. So we can now install it and measure, but it is restricted what we can do. So that's really one thing that you should take in mind when you use that in Europe. Yeah, so what Henk already told, authorized test data is also useful outside of IT. Yeah? So we want to extend it to the business so that they can see their own performance of their own site. So that's good. Things that we also walked into is that since a lot of people can add tests, and it became so popular at the moment that they just add a test, and then the ThousandEyes agent become overloaded with tests. So you have, for instance, 5-minute intervals that you can do some tests, and if you add tests that extend 5 minutes to be able to perform that, it will not function anymore. So manage that. That's indeed also what you have to do. One thing to mention is that we have used the support organization of ThousandEyes heavily. So just also to have an explanation of what we saw. So they are really helpful and knowledgeable. So that's also one thing that we have to mention is that they helped us a lot. So that's very good. And that's about it.